I'm going to share with you a new feature that was sneaked into Illustrator in early January 2021. Not many people know about it, and it's awesome. I think it's fair to say that for many years, we've needed a reliable mirroring feature inside of Illustrator. Well, it is here. So if I select my bird artwork, I can then go to the object menu, and we now have repeats. Now, this will only be visible if you've updated to the January 2021 version of Illustrator. And we have three. So I'm going to start off with grid. I'm going to left click on that. Then we get a four column, two row grid, which you can expand further. So if you drag the right hand widget on the frame, you can reveal more columns. You can also reveal more rows by dragging the bottom widget downwards, like so. At the top center, we have the horizontal spacing. So dragging left reduces the space. Dragging to the right hand side increases the spacing between those instances. You can go to the middle left hand side and you can increase the vertical spacing between those as well. Above and beyond that, well, then you've either got to go to the properties panel for further repeat options, or you could of course find them under the object menu by going to repeats and then choosing options. So in here, well, above and beyond the spacing, you've got grid types. The standard is grid, you've got brick by row, and you've got brick by column. I'm going to set mine back to brick by row. And then you can actually flip alternating rows. So I can flip horizontally, or I can flip vertically. I can do the same with columns. So I can flip horizontally, alternating columns, or I can flip them vertically as well. So I think in my case, I'm going to choose to flip some of those birds around in there and some of the columns around as well. When I'm done, I'll click OK. So from here, well, I'm just going to drag that back a little bit just to hide the beak that's sticking out there. And if you want to edit any of them, well, you just hover over any one of those visible instances. So if I just go to my larger window in here, hover over and double left click, then we go into a type of isolation mode. And I can give my bird a nice coloured hat, I think, to look a little more stylish. Touch of purple, I think, we'll do in there as well. Send that to the back. And you can see from here that every time I'm changing the artwork, each of those instances are then updating as well. So it's a really great way to be able to prototype and view the artwork live. I hit the escape key to come out of that editing mode, and that is the new repeat grid. The other type of repeat we have is radial. Giving you 8 instances by default, you can increase them by dragging the right-hand side widget upwards, or of course, dragging them down to reduce the number of widgets in there. You can also dictate whereabouts they're visible on that ring by going to 1/2 of the reveal, and you can drag them clockwise, or you can drag them counterclockwise and reset them by going and dragging them back down to the bottom. Like so. If you wish to increase or decrease the diameter, then it's the top half of the ring, drag away or drag back towards the center, and you can also spin them around as well, which is quite handy. But if you're really looking to get your artwork to dovetail perfectly, then you'll probably find you have to do that from the dialog boxes, either in the control panel, which I've got here as a floating version, or over on the right hand side of my screen here, you can see the properties panel as well. Radial repeats can also be edited by double left clicking on them. Choose whichever tools you need to edit and you'll see those changes update live. And that is radial repeat. Finally, we come to the mirror repeat. Now, when this appears on screen, you have two main widget functions. The first is on the inner lower edge that alters the gap between the two halves. The one at the very bottom will allow you to change the angle of where they're mirrored. There's one at the bottom, and then there's also one at the very top, which achieve the same thing. Of course, just like the previous two repeats, you can modify this in the initial mode and add content to it and see it update live, or in any point in the future as well. So all in all, I think that these repeat options are really great additions to Illustrator. I do, however, feel that some of these repeat functions definitely need some kind of snapping features built into them so that we can get nice clean seams between the instances, and also dragging some of those widgets around for changing like the diameter. So hopefully we'll see those in future updates to Illustrator. Thanks for watching, folks. As always, if you've enjoyed the video, please give it a thumbs up. If you want to create great looking artwork and save oodles of time, then subscribe and click on the bell so you don't miss a thing. And until next time, farewell.